Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back. Chapter 3, Applications of Definite Integrals. Lecture 2 of 2. Learning outcome for this lecture. So, at the end of the lecture, you should be able to, first one, find the revenue and cost function from the marginal revenue and marginal cost function. That is the first one. Second one, you should find the market equilibrium point. Third one, sketch and label consumer surplus, producer surplus regions and market equilibrium point. And final one is determine consumer surplus and producer surplus. So we have four learning outcomes, right? So this one is second subtopic in this chapter, which is 2.2, applications of integration in economics and business. So you should familiarize with these five keywords. So first one is revenue functions, denoted by Rx. Second one is cost function, denoted by Cx. Third one is consumer surplus, which is CS. Next one is producer surplus, PS. And final one is market equilibrium point, which is MEP. It's for revenue function, RX. Okay. So revenue function. The marginal revenue functions is the derivative of total revenue. So this one, if you are given revenue function, if you differentiate the revenue function, you will get marginal revenue function. Thus, the total revenue functions, Rx, is the integral with respect to x of the marginal revenue function. That is, Rx equals to integrations of r prime x with respect to dx, and you should have Rx plus k. Okay, so when x equals to 0, then there is no revenue, or r0 equals to 0. Therefore, k is equals to 0. So we have example 8 here. If the marginal revenue function is r prime x equals to 8 minus 6x minus 2x square, determine the total revenue function. So what we have to do here is we have to find total revenue function, which is we need to find Rx. Right. So Rx equals to integrations of r prime x. What is our r prime x? Which is 8 minus 6x minus 2x square dx. Okay, so we integrate this one. We should have 8x minus 3x square minus 2 over 3 x cubed plus k. Okay, so we need to find the value of k. So we know that when r equals to 0, r0 equals to 0. So if we substitute x equals to 0, so we have 8, 0 minus 3, 0 square minus 2 over 3, 0 cube plus k equals to 0. So therefore k equals to 0. So our final answer, therefore, rx equals to 8x minus 3x square minus 2 over 3x cube. Then example 8. Right, so example 9. Oh, this one is a bit long, right? The marginal revenue function for a product is r prime x equals to 500 minus x, where x is the number of product. Find the total revenue function. B, find the total revenue from the sales of 150 products. And finally, what is the additional revenue when the production level is increased from 150 to 200 products? Right. So question E. So total revenue function we need to find Rx, right? So Rx equals to integrations of 500 minus x dx. Okay, this one give us 500x minus x square over 2 plus k. We know that when r 0 equals to 0 implies k equals to 0. So therefore Rx equals to 500x minus x square over x square. This one is x square over 2. Done, question A. Alright. Question B, find the total revenue from the sale of 150 products. So which means our x equals to 150. So question B. Question B is we substitute 150 in revenue function. So this one we should have R 150 equals to 500 150 minus 150 square over 2. Alright, so this one is 63750. So therefore total revenue is total revenue is RM 63750. That is question B. Question C. What is the additional revenue? What is the additional revenue when the production level? So what is production level, which one is X, is increased from 150 to 200? So we already calculate 150. So we need to calculate for the 200. So we substitute R 200 equals to 500 minus 150 square, no, not 150, minus 200 square over 2. So this one give you 80,000. Question us additional revenue. So additional revenue equals to 80,000 minus 63750. Therefore this one is RM 16250. 16250. Yes, done. Example 9. And next part we will discuss about cost function. The marginal cost function is the derivative of total cost function, which is C prime x equals to derivative of Cx. So therefore the total cost function is the integral with respect to x of the marginal cost function. That is, Cx is given by equals to integral of marginal cost function with respect to x, and final answer is should be Cx plus k. When x equals to 0, then C0 equals to k, where k is the fixed cost. The marginal cost function is given by C prime x equals to 1.064 minus 0.005x. Find the total cost function if the fixed cost is ringgit Malaysia 16.5. 3-0. So first one, Cx is equals to integrations of 1.064 minus 0.005x dx, right? So we integrate this one, we should have 1.064x minus 0.0025x squared plus k. So we are given the fixed cost is the fixed cost is 16.3, therefore k equals to 16.30. therefore cx equals to 1.064x minus 0.0025x squared plus 16.30. That is example 10. Example 11. The marginal cost functions of a product is say prime x equals to x plus 100, where x is the number of products. Given that the total cost is 40,000 when x equals to 100, determine the total cost function. Right? So Cx equals to integrations of x plus 100 dx. This one equals to x square over 2 plus 100x plus k. Okay, so we have C 100 equals to 40,000. So this info is given to find the value of k. So what we need to do is we substitute 100 in cost function. So we have 100 square over 2 plus 100 multiplied by 100 plus k equals to 40,000. So k equals to 25,000. So therefore Cx equals to x square over 2 plus 100x plus 25,000. That is example 11. Next part is consumer surplus, denoted by CS. Alright, suppose P is the price that a consumer is willing to pay for quantity X of a product. The demand curve can be written as PX. So DX refer to demand curve. In general, the demand curve is decreasing function. Okay, denote this one. So if the market price is Y naught and the corresponding market demand is X naught, then those consumers who would be willing to pay more than this market price gain from the fact that the price is only Y naught. The total consumer gain is represented by area below the demand curve and above the line Y equals to Y naught, and this one is known as consumer surplus. Right? So we have two figures here. So this one is for linear and this one is for quadratic. So the CS or consumer surplus is always below the demand curve and above the line Y equals to Y naught. So this one is our CS. Right? So this one is our CS. Right? So how to calculate the CS? The formula for CS or consumer surplus is given by CS equals to integration from 0 to X naught demand function with respect to X, X naught, Y naught. That is consumer surplus. And next one is producer surplus, and denoted by PS. Suppose P is the price that a producer is willing to charge for a quantity X of a product is governed by the supply curve SX. So SX is supply curve. In general, the supply function is an increasing function. If the market price is Y naught and the corresponding market supply is X naught, then those producers who would be willing to supply the commodity below the market price gain from the fact that the price is Y naught. The total produced gain is represented by the area above the supply curve and below the line Y equals to Y naught, and this is known as producer surplus, TS. So this one we have supply curve, this one is linear, this one is quadratic. So above the supply curve and below the line Y equals to Y naught. So this one is producer surplus, this one is our producer surplus. So how to calculate the producer surplus? We have a formula for that, which is producer surplus is equals to X naught multiplied by Y naught minus integration of 0 to X naught supply curve with respect to dx. That is producer surplus. And last one is the market equilibrium point, MEP. I would say MEP lah. Okay, the point of intersection. Okay, the point of intersection of the demand curve and the supply curve. So which means this one, you have to take dx equals to Sx. It's called the equilibrium point of a free market. The coordinate of market equilibrium point is X naught, Y naught, where Y naught is the price at which the producer is willing to supply, and X naught is the quantity of the goods purchased by the consumer and supplied by the producer. The equilibrium condition is expressed by the equation this one. So we will use the X equals to Sx in order to calculate the MEP. Alright, so this is the final graph. So we have quantity here, we have price here, so we have supply curve here, we have demand curve here. So we have, so X naught, Y naught is happening here. So this one is X naught, this one is Y naught. The CS is above here and the producer supply is down here. That is MEP. Example 12. Find the consumer surplus at the price level of 8 when the demand function is dx equals to 20 minus 0.05x. Right? So price level, so this one indirectly we have this one equals to dx when the demand function is dx equals to. So what we have to do is, so we are given dx equals to 20 minus 0.05x. Right, so dx is equals to 8, so this one is 8 equals to 20 minus 0.05x. So this one x equals to 240, which means so our x naught equals to 240 implies Y naught equals to 8. This one is coming from dx. Okay, but question asked to find consumer surplus. Consumer surplus, CS. So CS, oops, sorry, not this way. Consumer surplus equals to integration from 0 to X naught, which is 240. And demand function is 20 minus 0.05x dx minus x naught y naught, which is 240 multiplied by 8. Okay, so we integrate this one, we should have 20x minus 0.0 25 x square, and limit of integration is 0 to 4, 0 minus 1, 9 to 0. So next step is we substitute, so we should have 20 to 4, 0 minus 0.025 240 square minus 0. So y minus 0 here is, if I substitute 0 in this function, I got 0. So to be safe, I put this one. This one is not compulsory. Minus 1920. Press your calculator and your final answer should be 1440. Because this one is CS, so my conclusion is here. So therefore the CS is, don't forget the RM, 1440. That is example 12. Example 13. Find the producer surplus at the price level of 20. So this one is our SX, and the supply function is SX equals to 2 plus 0.0002x squared. So this one basically you have to solve. So we have SX equals to 2 plus 0.0002x squared. Okay, so our SX equals to 20, so this one equals to 20 equals to 2 plus 0.0002x squared. Okay, we simplify this one. Simplify this one, you should have simplify this one first. So this one we have 0.0002x squared equals to 18. Simplify this one, I should have x square equals to 90,000. Okay, this one I do x minus x square minus 90,000 equals to 0. So x minus 300, x plus 300 equals to 0. So therefore x equals to 300 and x equals to negative 300. Ignore y. So x is normally number of products now. So therefore our x naught is 300, implies to y naught equals to 20. Right? So question asked to find the producer surplus. So the PS here, so the PS equals to X naught, Y naught. So 300 multiplied by 20 minus integration from 0 to 300. 2 plus 0.0002. Oh, I should. Alright, so this one is 300, 2 plus 0.0002x square dx. Okay, so this one equals to 6,000 minus 2x plus 0.0002x cube over 3. So this one is 300, this one is 0. So oh, this one is 6,000 and this one is 6,000 minus 2,300 plus 0.0002,300 cube over 3 and minus 0. So sorry. So minus 0 here. So you press your calculator, you should have 3600. So therefore the producer surplus is RM 3600. So this one is example 13. Example 14, find the equilibrium price. So this one we need to find what is Y, consumer surplus, so what is our CS, and producer surplus, what is PS. At the equilibrium price level, if dx equals to 20 minus 0.05x and sx equals to 2 plus 0.0002x squared. So first one, we need to solve what is y. So we need to solve dx equals to sx. So what is dx? 20 minus 0.05x sx equals to 2 plus 0.0002x squared. Simplify this one, we have 0.0002x squared plus 0.05x minus 18 equals to 0. So I simplify this one, I should have x squared plus 250x minus 90,000 equals to 0. So this one, x minus 200, x plus 450 equals to 0. So x equals to 200 and x equals to negative 450, and this one we ignore. So therefore x equals to 200, but the question asks y, not x. So we need to find y. So we can use dx or sx here. So I use dx. So what I need, I just substitute 200 in dx or sx function. So d 200 equals to 20 minus 0.05 200, and this one equals to 10. So therefore the equilibrium price is RM 10. And that is why. So next one is we need to find the consumer surplus. I'll do it here. Okay, so the consumer surplus, so first one is consumer surplus. So we have to integrate from 0 to 200, and we have to use the demand function, which is 20 minus 0.05 x dx minus 210. Okay, so this one we have 20x minus 0.025x square, and 200 here, 0 here, minus 2000. Okay, next step we substitute, so we have 20, 200, minus 0.025, 200 square, minus 0, Okay, so minus 2000, so therefore this one equals to 1000. Okay, so conclude the CS is RM 1000. This is our CS. Next is we have to find our PS. So PS, I hope I can fit in here. So PS equals to 200 multiplied by 10 minus 0 to 200. What is supply function? 2 plus 0.0002x square dx. Alright, so this one is 2000 minus, okay, so this one is 2x plus 0.0002x cube over 300. Okay, next one is we substitute. So this one we have 2000 minus 2. Why 300 there? This one is not 300. Sorry guys, that one is not 300. That one is 200. Okay, so next one is 2000 minus 200 plus 0.000 to 200 cube over 3. And last one is V minus 0. So this answer is 1066.67. So conclusion is up here. So therefore the producer surplus is RM 1066.67. Done. Example 14. Now example 15, the demand function and supply function in ringgit Malaysia of a product are given by as dx equals to negative x square minus 6x plus 200 and sx equals to 4x respectively, where x is the number of products. Determine the market equilibrium point. So sketch the two function and mark the region that represent the consumer surplus and producer surplus. When the market is in equilibrium, determine the value of consumer surplus and producer surplus. So question A, we have to find MEP. Okay, so let's find MEP. So MEP, so we have to solve dx equals to sx. So what is dx? Dx is negative x square minus 6x plus 200 equals to 4x. Okay, we solve this one. So we have x square plus 10x minus 200 equals to 0. So this one is x minus 10. X plus 20 equals to 0. So we have x equals to 10, x equals to negative 20, x equals to negative 20. We ignore. So therefore, x equals to 10. But question asks point. So we need to find y. Okay, so y, so question this one. So S10 equals to 4. What is happening? 4. So this one is 40. So therefore, MEP equals to 10, 40. Done. Question A. Question B, we have to sketch the two function. This one. So question B, I'll do it here. Question B, so we have to sketch the function. So the x is quadratic. So as x is a linear. So basically we should have something like this one. Okay. So this one. Okay, so this one is x. So this one is y. Okay, so we have quadratic 200. So let's say we have this way. Okay, and this one we have something like this one. Okay, so xy, so this one is sx, so this one is dx. Okay, so we have to draw here. Oh, hang on. Let me do it properly. So this one. Okay. So this one is 10 basically. So this one is supposedly 40. Alright. So this one is 200. So this one is... you have to shade it properly. Okay. Until the end. So this one is CS. So this one is PS. Then, so sketch the two function and mark the region. So we sketch two function as x dx. We mark the region as CS PS. Then question B. Okay. Next one is we have to find consumer surplus and producer surplus again. So for the CS we have to integrate from 0 to 10. Demand function negative x square minus 6x plus 200 dx minus 10 40. Okay, so integrate this one, we have negative x cubed over 3 minus 3x square minus 3x square plus 200x 0 to 10 minus 400. Okay, so this one we have negative 10 cubed over 3 minus 3 10 square plus 200 10 minus 0 then minus 400. And answer is, I don't have enough space, so I put here. So 966.67. Okay. So therefore, the CS is RM 966.67. That is our consumer surplus. Next one is our producer surplus. So PS equals to x naught multiplied by y naught minus integrate from 0 to 10 supply function, which is for x dx. Okay, so this one is 400 minus 2x square 10, 0. So next step is we substitute here. So this one, oh, down here. So we substitute 400 minus 210 square minus 0. So this one we should have 200. Okay, so therefore the producer surplus is Rm 200. Done example 15. We finished chapter 3 by now, and this one is the final one. Yeah, thank you so much guys, have fun.